So you mentioned that you have to be a meeting on the website. What if it locks you out, or the internet goes off, or whatever issue that it just automatically locks you out? Does that mean that the hours won't be recorded?
There's no way to say. So it does require a stable internet connection for there to be on there and logging in and out. That's a what if question. I don't know. And why I say I don't know is because they don't know. If you've been in there for 15 minutes and then your internet connection was poor and it logged you out, they can't guarantee that. That's why it says best practices for doing. That's why I invite everyone to do that first section when you go in, because there's also a video with that under the student help tab after you go in from that first section that's going to tell you best practices. So that's it's always log out after. So if you're somewhere that's got internet that goes in and out or is a little bit sketchy, I can't promise you that you're going to be able to see that the way that you want to. But even on Cengage, it wouldn't work like that. Does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you.
They added their name on CMIN. It was not their legal name. Does it have to stay? Yeah, Shannon, it would have to stay that way in there. I can look and see if you want to have, if you want to have that student email me, I can go in and see if I can adjust the name under their profile. Alyssa, yes.
When it comes to graduating, are y'all still going by that list that was in the senior aesthetics tab to have completed for practicals, or what are y'all judging by as far as percentage of practicals done versus Cengage versus the mocks, like in order to graduate?
So in order to graduate with a practical sheet, there was that old practical sheet, and depending on how long you've been around, Alyssa, were you here whenever we had the base system?
I was here, I started November 8th.
Okay, so we were just kind of getting around that. So you get the practicals that you have, listed on that sheet, that's really what we're looking for you to do, and it's in the senior aesthetics tab. I put two of those in because people were close to graduating and they kind of just needed almost like a dump for a lot of the stuff that they had. I think where people have had the most challenges is right now we have practicals in 14 weeks, or in 16 weeks rather. I say 14 because two of those weeks are your state board. So you do need to have gone through the state board and passed it two times. You do need to go through all 3 days unless you've already notified your instructor that you can't be there for one. The first is a packing day, the second is a walk through, and then the third you actually proctors the exam for you. Now, for those practicals, it turns out usually to be about 100, somewhere between 130 and 150 something, depending on when you were enrolled. The other question that I get about the practicals is, well, what if we've already done all of them? Well, then you do more. And why I say that you do more is because if you were here on campus, you would be doing a ProSkin 5 times a week, a ProSkin 63, 4 or 5 times a week. So really, you a lot of them will repeat. You just repeat them and submit them under that weekly hours reporting. Even after you've finished, if you haven't finished the program by the time that you get through those practical requirements.
Okay, yeah, because I just don't know what all I've done and not done, because I have the list I printed off at home that I just, I guess, like, I kind of lost track of, like, highlighting out what I've done and not done, so I guess y'all would know more than me on what is left to do, I guess. Is that what I asked Ms. May about that, too, or?
Ms. Bankin, you got, and honestly, what we do is usually share the practicals that you have because they're saved in the drive if there have been any changes, so we still have access to them.
Okay.
Okay. And then Monica, did you say if we were just reading chapters and see if it will record? No, so it will record if you were reading, but what I'm going to defer you to on that, go into
this morning I was trying to get into whatever lecture we had at like 10:15, and I've had this issue kind of a few times where I'll try to join, but I never get let in, and so then I end up just not even getting into it at all. How should I? Oh, Tammy, I guess I have the same issue too. How do I fix that, or is it like, I don't know?
If it's there, so usually, so the all lectures should always begin, or we should have the screen up and going by about 10:15, and then we give about 10 minutes of leeway and start around. I mean, if everyone is in there, I usually start at about 10:25, but if you aren't able to get in, we might need to examine. Like, I can be there in the morning and see exactly what's going on, but as long as we're using the same link, are you using the link that she's posting in Google Classroom, or are you using the one that's just the standard link in there?
No, I'm using the one that she posts, like, with her announcement of it.
Okay, so we might have to do a little bit of investigating there then to see why you aren't able to get in, because I know if you were using the one in the classroom, people were doing that before, and that's what confused me even whenever I was starting this, but we'll see tomorrow morning.
Okay, sounds good.
Someone kept it on the hand raise, sorry.
Oh, no, you're fine. You're absolutely fine. I'm in no rush. I just want to make sure that if we have any of those, if you're having those challenges or those questions, I'm sure that there are other people who are having the same. So I don't want to hold anything back. That's what I'm here to do, is make it a little bit easier and make the process go smoother, go more smoothly. So what other questions might we have? Yes, Tim.
Versus doing our actual book work prior to our different time tracking methods, like when I would do certain practicals that I couldn't record an hour long video because I couldn't upload it, then I would track that through just being logged into my tab. So when it comes down to graduation and I have my 1,000 hours, is it going to be very specific of, do you have this many 300 hours worth of recorded videos? And am I going to have videos to qualify for my practical hours?
No. So as long as the practical applications themselves have been completed, it's okay. So that's and the reason that that's a little tricky is because, so the State Board of Texas used to make it like 300 hairdressings. They have, you know, they had X amount of whatever, but it's not really possible or viable to do that, especially whenever we're dealing with students. We have no idea how long it's going to take someone to complete something, how long it takes for them to learn. So as long as you've completed all of those, you should be fine. Let's see. 2 weeks due to problems on my storage issues, will I be able to make up the hours along my graduation date? You're very welcome, Tammy. So Monica, with that, that's a question where you're going to have to ensure that you stay in touch with your advisor and let her know that we've got to tell myself, we've got to tell someone on the data entry team that you had a storage issue and weren't able to get those in. And it's not that it will push back your graduation date, because as soon as those are in, then the hours will be reported. Yes, Alyssa.
Is it our advisors who graduate us, like the Miss May or Miss Erica? Is it whoever? Is it them who we talk to? Who I guess is like, okay, we keep checking back with them. They're like, okay, we got it. You're done. You can graduate now. Like, is it them that approve it, or?
Yes, your exit interview. And so for your exit interview, well, we're ensuring that you have your hours. We ensure with Bianca, our office manager, that you have paid in full. We ensure that you have done your mock state boards. We ensure that your SIN gauge is 100% done, which will now become a CIMA, is 100% completed. And that you've completed all of your practicals in Google Classroom. So the
the hours, say that we are done with Cengage, say we are done with our two state board mocks and we are paid in full, but we are slightly short or we are short of practicals, how do they navigate that? What do we do when that time, like, when that time comes?
You'll spend the rest of your time doing the practicals because you can exceed hours. There's nothing that says that. You have to meet the practical requirements to complete the program.
Okay.
Because we've had students on campus who've had as many as 775 or 780 hours because there are model requirements whenever you're here for them to finish their models. So you have to, it doesn't matter if you go over the 750 hours, it's just you have to be paid in full and you have to meet all of those requirements. I've also had people who've gone as many as 775 hours because they didn't complete their Cengage while they were in school getting those hours.
Okay, I feel like that was like a definite question, like probably a lot of people had as far as graduating.
Thank you guys for your time. I appreciate it very much. And just don't hesitate to call me. I don't want any.